In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of diaphragm. Let's look at its attachment, its origin and insertion. Origin of diaphragm is very, very wide. Basically, origin is whole this part, this kind of a contour of ribcage. So it attaches on the ribcage 7 through 12 ribs, like 7 through 12 ribs, okay, here, and it attaches on lumbar spines here. This part is called crura. Crura is like this, crura. Crura means leg. So this part is rex of diaphragm. This is left part, and this is right part. In anatomy books, right crura looks longer than left crura. And this part is about lumbar 1 through 3. First lumbar spine through third. Or in some people, it can extend to fourth or below. It depends on people. But basically, on the lumbar spines. Okay? So this is the basic attachment. Oh, yes. And I want you to notice this part and this part. This light blue part is the medial arcuate ligament. Medial arcuate ligament. And this yellow part is lateral arcuate ligament. Lateral arcuate ligament. There's medial, lateral, and there's also one more arcuate ligament, which is here. This part is median arcuate ligament. This is median, this is medial, and lateral. Basically, three ligaments. Okay? These are very important. I will explain why this is important later. So this is basic origin of diaphragm. Let's check insertion of diaphragm. This is here, this part. This part is called central tendon. You see the letter here? This is central tendon. Yeah, basically, this is tendon. You know, muscle goes to tendon. However, this is interesting thing. The central tendon doesn't attach on bone. Usually, tendon attaches on the bone, like Achilles tendon. Achilles tendon attaches on calcaneus. However, the central tendon does not attach on the bone. I think this is very interesting thing. Anyway, insertion of diaphragm is central tendon. I will change the picture to show you the easy way to see the diaphragm. So this is front view. Contour of diaphragm is like this. Yes, like this. This is just, you know, rough contour of diaphragm. And above diaphragm, there's heart and there's lung. This is just, you know, simplified version of diaphragm. Actually, it's like this, you know. Anyway, and when diaphragm contracts, it brings down, then air comes into lungs, right? So diaphragm is like a arch or dome kind of the shape. That's why we can breathe, okay? Now let's go back to the first picture. What is important thing about this ligament? What is important about medial arcuate ligament and lateral arcuate ligament? Here's the thing. Here is ligament, right? This is medial and this is lateral. What is this? What is this muscle? This one is psoas major. Psoas major. This one is quadratus lumborum. Via these ligaments, there is fascial connection with psoas major and quadratus lumborum. Ah, that sounds very interesting. So, you can say psoas and quadratus lumborum have fascial connection to the diaphragm. That is very, very important. Let's say if quadratus lumborum gets tight, you know, it can affect diaphragm, don't you think? Because there is fascial connection. Or if psoas gets tight, it can affect diaphragm because there is fascial connection. Vice versa, if diaphragm is not functioning very well, this tightness can affect psoas and quadratus lumborum, don't you think? So this connection, the deep core connection, is very, very important, especially quadratus lumborum is involved for low back pain, and psoas is involved for hip dysfunction and core dysfunction. So diaphragm, quadratus lumborum, and psoas major, this connection is very, very important. And there's one more ligament here. This is median arcuate ligament. There's no muscle attachment here, but this is important part. This is abdominal aorta. You know, aorta comes through this arch, then becomes abdominal aorta. If this ligament gets tight, it can compress celiac trunk. Celiac trunk is very important artery for internal organs. So this ligament is very important. Not much for muscular connection, but for internal organ, this is very important place. Okay? So mainly, I explained you the three ligaments, lateral, medial, and median arcuate ligament. And these two ligaments, lateral and medial arcuate ligaments, have connection with psoas and quadratus lumborum. So this is the basic anatomy of diaphragm. If you liked today's video, please like, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.